Yeah, I'm looking for some of the other secrets that I missed, the spheres. I turned the brightness way up too. Yo. Oh shit. I should have ran out there. Actually looked like a tranquilizer gun or something. Oh shit. How come that guy doesn't shoot you? I think I got this one already. Yeah, the game looks way different when you have the brightness turned way up, huh? And I drowned. Forgot you can't hold your breath very long while you're mortal. Okay, maybe I didn't get that one. Yeah. All right. Yo, what's up, Iowa? Did you finish it? Field research. It's hard to see what's on the picture here. Hear the blob running amok. That part's crazy, dude. What's going on, Maiden? How you doing, buddy? I'm just looking for these hidden orbs now on here. So Bear with me. What's going on, Fatality?
The next secret can be found upon running across the rooftop of a farmhouse. You'll jump down into a wagon full of dead pigs. Upon getting out, push the cart to the left instead of the right, hop on top, and pull a plank off of the side of the building. Upon...
I don't think I got this one either. Yeah, I had a good day. Just another way at work. Yeah, you were, dude. All of a sudden you start talking in the stream. I'm like, wait a minute, weren't you in the party? It's all good, though. I still want to know what's up with all these baby chicks. Yeah, my good buddy that I grew up with is coming over on Wednesday and Thursday. He's from Colorado now, too. Or he's living in Colorado now. So I look forward to seeing him. The chicks are ammo. Chicken nuggets, more like it. The game does look better with the brightness up, not gonna lie. With the standard brightness, it looks more like Limbo. I still don't get what's up with the baby chicks, man. What am I doing wrong here? I need more baby chicks. More! There we go. More baby chicks. I just woke up. Work today, got used to waking up late. I just got home from work. I got one more day. Hey, what's going on, Joey? How you been? Lot of piggy. It's your day off. Nice. Wee wee wee, that one's called. Alright, so I'm cheating. I am using a walkthrough because I just want to do this and get it over with.
Entering inside of the farmhouse, you will grab the rope swing. You will swing back and forth, jumping to the left and across the gap in order to find the secret.
Don't get me wrong, I did finish the game legitly. Now I'm finding all these hidden spheres. Alright, what's next?
The fourth secret is one of the most obvious in the game. Upon completing a puzzle where you're able to throw a safe or a vault off of a high plank of wood and destroy the ground, you can then jump down the hole which you created, and you can go left or right. You should notice that there is a yellow wire, which is always a good indicator of a nearby secret, leading into the left room through the vent. So make sure you open the vent, walk through into the secret room, where you can find your next secret.
Yeah, I like both of them, man. I think Limbo, I think the puzzles were a little bit more challenging in Limbo, but this one is just really well designed and mind-blowing. Bad piggy. You're gonna end up goring me to death. Now we're talking about food again. It's too early. What happened with the blob of limbs? Didn't you see the ending last night? Well, hopefully if I get through this fast enough, I'll show you. We'll see. We will see. But yeah, the game is awesome, dude. I would love this. One of these nights, maybe I'll go through Limbo and then this game back to back. But yeah, it was funny. I glitched the game last night. The only way to save myself was to load my recent checkpoint. I think this is the one I got already. I remember when they were green jello before they had to change it to jelly. That's death. Death. I'm having a brain fart even though I just did this like a few days ago. PS4 just crashed, that's not good. Let's see if I can reach that. I can if I jump. That's not good. Pretty sure I already got this one. Yep. Just in case.
The fifth hidden item can be found at this checkpoint as you reach a broken down sign where you slide down a roof and then jump across a small gap to hang onto a pipe. Instead of going up to the top of the pipe to proceed through the mission, slide down to the bottom of
that
the
one
pipe,
I got.
Watch out so you don't accidentally fall off and kill yourself, and then jump across the gap to grab onto the ladder. Once on the ladder, climb your way down slowly into the hidden room where you will easily spot the collectible.
What's going on, man?
Now, this secret can be found from this checkpoint or the checkpoint after it, as long as you pay close attention. The checkpoint after the one I showed you on screen, you have to backtrack just a foot and a half. So you might want to keep that in mind instead. But you should go back into your submarine during this section and hop over a small gate, which you recently opened, and then crash through a red door. You'll notice that there is a large series of ladders and yet another red door. If you follow those ladders kind of behind you, you should notice the yellow cable I was mentioning earlier. If you go to the bottom, you can charge into
a
small little crate there that's blocking an opening, and then follow downward and to the left until you're able to get out of your submarine.
That one I did not know.
Now, once we get out of our submarine, there is a small puzzle. Get to the shore, climb up the ladder, and then use the mindless guy to get on top of the submarine. Once he's on top, you can uncouple yourself from the mind reader thing, get back into your submarine, and then you'll need to use a charge in order to get the dude on top to connect to the other connector. Once you do that, go back and connect yourself to the first connector, and then you'll be able to control the guy in the background. Once you're able to control the guy in the background, just lead him straight to the secret and have him open it.
Hey, what's going on, Miss Blush? Yeah, I like this game a lot. I'm looking for secrets now. Is this the submarine part? I think. I'm not sure. Maybe not. Let's see, where's the submarine? Oh, right here. The bathosphere. You'll be alone a lot more often. Why is that? Did you get laid off? That's not good. It's good that you'll be around more. I only got one more day left of work, and that's my week off. Oh, that sucks, dude. Do you have to have knee surgery? Nice. Yeah, I'll probably have to get an MRI and all that shit. I already did all that stuff. It's not fun, man. So good luck. Hopefully it's not too serious. I had a lot of stuff messed up with my knee. I had bucket handle meniscus, along with my ACL was shot, like completely shot. Don't remember what the hell. What's up here? Why don't I do this? It'll be a lot easier. Did it? Nice. I'm getting the missing spheres that I missed for hidden ending. Now, where's my bathysphere? That's the question. National Topless Day, and people are actually doing it. Oh, see, the door's not even open. How the hell do I open the door? Damn it. Looks like I gotta do this anyway. So be it. Wait a minute, how the fuck? Hold on. I gotta check something.
We are almost at the halfway point, and for this secret, we will close the door behind us and then crash through a wooden panel that is on the ceiling or roof of the. And you'll be able to control the guy in the background. Notice that there is.
I'm rewatching this quick.
So you might want to keep that in mind instead, but you should go. Item can be found at this checkpoint as you reach a broken down sign where you slide down a roof and then jump across a small gap to hang onto a pipe. Instead of going up to the top of the pipe to proceed through the mission, slide down to the bottom of the pipe, watch out so you don't accidentally fall off and kill yourself, and then jump across the gap to grab onto the ladder. Once on the ladder, climb your way down
That sounds good.
into the hidden room. room where you will easily spot the collectible. Now, this secret can be found from this checkpoint or the checkpoint after it, as long as you pay close attention. The checkpoint after the one I showed you on screen, you have to backtrack just a foot and a half, so you might want to keep that in mind instead. But you should go back into your submarine during this section and hop over a small gate, which you recently opened, and then crash through a red door.
So yeah, I still need to open up that gate. How the hell do I do that? Made of shrimp grits. Shrimp and grits. Does anybody remember how to open this door right here? Because I don't. Go through the hole with your dude, make your way up top. I did that, but then what? Like, where's the switch? So you gotta get out, swim. Well, I don't remember how to open that giant door. Trying to do this as fast as I can so I can show you guys this hidden ending, hopefully tonight. But what do I do up here then? Maybe I have to go to the right? I don't remember. I don't think it was all the way to the right though. But maybe, I'll look. Oh yeah, it was up here. Betcha. Switch must be over here. Ta-da. There we go. Now, check this shit out, Iowa. You're gonna wanna watch this. I turned the brightness way up, by the way, Iowa, in the options. Oh god, you guys are making me fucking hungry. Stop. I'm not gonna eat something at like 4:30 in the morning. Oh shit, get back in there. Hell yeah, I'll take some spaghetti. I'm actually pretty damn hungry. I didn't eat that much at work today. Friends in low places, there we go.
Series of ladders and yet another red door. If you follow those ladders kind of behind you, you should notice the yellow cable I was mentioning earlier. If you go to the bottom, you can charge into the small little crate there that's blocking an opening, and then follow downward and to the left until you're able to get out of your submarine.
Yeah, steak sounds good. Grilled tenderloin with some, like...
Now, once we get out of our submarine, there is a small puzzle. Get to the shore, climb up the ladder, and then use the mindless guy to get on top of the submarine. Once he's on top, you can uncouple yourself from the mind reader thing, get back into your submarine, and then you'll need to use a charge in order to get the dude on top to connect to the other connector. Once you do that, go back and connect yourself to the first connector, and then you'll be able to control the guy in the background. Once you're able to control the guy in the background, just lead him straight to the secret and have him open it.
Alright, I just gotta see this next one.
We are almost at the halfway point, and for this secret, we will close the door behind us and then crash through a wooden panel that is on the ceiling or roof of this.
Oh, this is where you're trying to escape
the
trip.
The rest of the story, we would be going right, but instead we're going to go left to the very edge of the area, and you'll notice some pipes on the wall. In order to break these pipes, just make sure you jump into them 2 times, which will release the ladder. At that point, you'll want to park your submarine, get on top of it, and make the jump across to the small ledge. From that ledge, you can then climb onto the ladder. At the top of the ladder, continue to the left, and you'll find the secret. Open it, as always, to unlock the achievement.
It sounds good, you guys. Yep, I'm to the she-bitch part, yep. You guys are not helping, I'm starving. I gotta go hit that switch, huh? No, I'm dead. Let me see, yeah, there it is. I'll get right to the part. If I'm gonna do this, I need to hurry as fast as I can. It's already 20 to 5. Fourteen secrets. That sounds good too, man, and I'd eat almost anything right now. Not a big fan of cooked tuna. Even when you cook tuna, you're not supposed to cook it much at all. It's supposed to still have that pink look to it. Same with salmon. Sneaky, sneaky. All right, on to the next. Oh, stupid advertisement, really? Sorry to bother you, Come but on.
Now, this next one is a little bit involved, but isn't too bad. It happens during the quote-unquote 20-man puzzle. You'll come to the bottom floor on the very left, where you can release these three guys from the crate above by completing the puzzle as shown on screen. After releasing them, take them back to where you came from, and you'll notice some wooden planks covering a small hole with a yellow cable nearby. Have them help you destroy this so that you can get inside.
Do what? Huh. I gotta see this. Oh, I see. This is the 20-man puzzle, right?
Once inside of this area, you'll want to climb down the ladder all the way to the bottom, where you'll find a torch.
Is this the 20-man one? Yeah, it is. I thought there was a sign that said 20 over here by him, though, for some reason. No, power's not even on, that's why. Gotta turn the power on first. How easily I forget Iowa. All right, so check this out, Iowa. You're gonna want to remember all these. That goes with anybody who wants to do this game. I can't do this part yet. I need people. What's going on, guys? Strong bridge. Yeah, I like almonds too. Alright, maybe now I can do it. Wasabi. All aboard. So you want to get to this part right here, Iowa. Check this out, and everybody. Sneaky, sneaky. Whoa. Okay, maybe I need to look at the video a little longer. There's a dog right there.
Grab the torch and then use the torch to defend yourself against the packs of wolves until you can make your way all the way to the left of this cave. At the very end, you will find a secret.
That one was cool. Oh, you would laugh if there was nothing, but I am
cheating. Again, you need to point the torch at the wolves so they don't attack you.
After I got my throat ripped out. I'm surprised there's not a trophy to finish this game without dying once. Because that would be actually kind of fun to try. What's next? Let me take a look.
The next secret can be found at this checkpoint where you come through a vault door, get into some water, and get chased by the girl from the ring. So for this one, what we want to do is dunk ourselves into the right panel in order to get that girl to come chase us so that she's far away from where we entered. Once she comes to us, you're going to want to climb out of the water and make sure she doesn't grab your feet on the way out or else you will die. And this is basically just to have her in this area so you can have more time in order to swim the other way. So once you're back on ground level, jump into the water on the left and quickly swim down and across in order to find a small hidden room where obviously there's a secret.
I streamed it. It's on my YouTube if you want to watch it. I will. I think we got that one where the girl chases you. But where was that one? That was right after that. I think. I might have went a little too far here. Yeah, this is when you're immortal. I don't want to be immortal yet. I think I went too far. I gotta look at the picture of the load point screen again. I think we got this one though. I'm just double checking. Yeah, it's right after the shockwave, I think. But which one was that?
The next secret can be found at this checkpoint where you come through a vault.
You come through a vault door? Alright, it's Not that one. That one. This is it right here. I'm just double checking. I'm pretty sure we got this one. Yeah, we did get this one. I remember now. Yep. It's not lit up. That means I got it. Alright, next.
Found at this checkpoint where you come through a vault door, get into some water.
That was number 9 of 13 or 14.
So for this one, what we want to do is dunk ourselves into the right panel, come out of the water, and make sure she doesn't grab your feet on the way out. Swimming in front of us to get to there. Take a breath, you'll want to swim up, and you'll already notice the yellow cable on the side of the building. We will have quite a bit of swimming in front of us to get to there, so get up to the top and then swim across into the next room, downward, and then go back to the left once you reach the bottom of the next area.
Oh, damn.
Once there, you should notice a panel. What you'll need to do to open this panel is interact with the middle in order to spin it, and then interact with the top to pull it down and release the window, opening the door.
Damn, this one's really, really sneaky.
Once you open this door, just swim to the left in order to find the secret.
Alright, that looks easy enough, though. Let's check out this one, dude. This is after you get killed or whatever, and you can breathe forever. It's weird. Yeah, there's Alien 3 for the Genesis, dude. That's such a good game. Tiny Toon Adventures. Down where it's wetter? Ooh. Under the sea. Under the sea. It's the sphincter door, I remember. Did you do this one, Iowa? X-Men versus Street Fighter. Nicktoons Racing, that looks funny. There it is. Unfathomable. Alright, let me see what's next. Moving right along.
secret can be found during the small quote-unquote clock. This panel. Then you'll want to wait for the beam of light to be on the right clock puzzle. What you'll want to do is rotate the piece to cast a shadow directly in the middle of this panel. Then you'll want to wait for the beam of light to be on the right-hand side, and then you'll want to run back to where you came from, left, and jump down, and keep running until you can swim. Once you can swim, swim downwards, and then to the right. Now what you'll want to notice is that the thing you spun has two sides that are identical to each other, and on the other side of the spinny thing, or the clock, you can find the collectible. So this thing in the water right here is the other half of what we were spinning. You'll need to have it in the water so that you're pulling yourself up, or else it'll be above water and unreachable. So once that's there, just swim up to the top of the water, get on top, and take the secret.
Dude, this next one's crazy. Which part is that, though? It's this. Thinking of going for the one up. It's not easy to achieve. I mean, it is, but I didn't see what Mario game it was. This is your favorite part, Iowa. Watch what you gotta do. Clockwork. So that platform has a identical platform on the opposite side. That's why you have to have it going straight up so you can reach this one. We're getting there.
This next secret can be found after doing a couple of physics-based puzzles with a push box. Once you bring the push box back up from where you came, you can go around back into the room that you need to be in. Once you're in that room, instead of pushing the box where it needs to be to progress the story, push it all the way to the right-hand side of the room. Once the box is all the way on the right-hand side, push the pad in order to gain enough height to push the button on the side of the wall next to the yellow cable. Upon pushing the button, you'll notice that a platform on the right-hand side lowers. Now you'll need to push the box again and jump onto that platform. And once you jump on top, it'll start raising itself back up. Once you reach the top of this platform, just go to the right-hand side to find the secret.
Crazy. And another ad. I think I'm pretty close, but I gotta do all this shit now. I can't. What was the trophy for the last one? Clockwork or something like that. Oops, bad timing right there. And again. Why Saturday? My week off starts on Wednesday, Miss Blush. Get up there, almost. A little too early. Sounds good. You will try. Yeah, it is. Definitely. We should have enough time to do the hidden ending. It's only 10 after 5, so yeah, we got this, you guys. No, not everything. I usually do it for new people who come in and they, no matter what you say, they always try to one-up you. You know what I mean? But anyone can win the one-up award. That doesn't mean I'll give it away, though.
Room per reflection.
That's what that one was.
Secret can be found during the elevator puzzle. After getting to the bottom of the elevator shaft and bringing yourself back up, you'll want to go and retrieve the goons and bring them back to the elevator, only allowing half of them into the elevator. It doesn't have to be exactly half, but you will need to leave some outside and have some inside, at least three in each group, in order to complete this.
This next one sounds confusing. This one sounds weird. I think it's this one. And I'm dead. Get in here, goon. I don't have enough guys up here. Only got the one. Yeah, he's not gonna lift me up there. So, I think I gotta redo this.
You gotta make sure at least three of those guys stay up on top of the elevator. Nah, he was just trying to one-up me, Fatality. I don't think he's being real. Fuck, I just did it again. Too many of them fell. Now there's no one up there. Yeah, dude. Makrupa. Or must I? Must I? Alright, this time I can do it. No, how do you get him to stop fucking doing that? Just need a couple of them. That. That's how you do it. Right? That's how you split them up. Now I should be able to do it. Office space. Alright, so now the special treat for you guys.
Now the the 14th and final collectible slash secret slash dire leg slash whatever the game calls it can only be attained if you have all 13 of the previous secrets unlocked, as all of the wires are used to power the object you'll be getting into. Once you reach this area where you crouch under a small grate in the floor and get next to a ladder, climb up to the top of the ladder following the 13 yellow cables. Upon entering this room, you'll notice a small somewhat of a spaceship slash UFO on the right-hand side of the screen. In order to activate it, go inside, where you'll be able to grab an item even though you can't see that you're grabbing it. You need to pull it slightly to the left in order to get the white pull you into this room.
Hold on.
You onto the yellow hanging wire, and then pull yourself to the very top.
This part looks crazy.
Once you reach the top, you'll now need to use the other group in order to push you up to the secret. It's pretty simple once you reach this area, but you will need to have the two separate groups or else you won't be able to reach the collectible. So yeah, that's it. Now the 14th and final collectible slash secret slash dire leg slash whatever the game calls it can only be attained if you have all 13 of the previous secrets unlocked, as all of the wires are used to power the object you'll be getting into. Once you reach this area where you crouch under a small grate in the floor and get next to a ladder, climb up to the top of the ladder following the 13 yellow cables. Upon entering this room, you'll notice a small somewhat of a spaceship slash UFO on the right-hand side of the screen. In order to activate it, go inside, where you'll be able to grab an item even though you can't see that you're grabbing it. You need to pull it slightly to the left in order to get the white lights to turn orange. After that, wait a few seconds for the lights to turn off, and then exit the craft in order to unlock your final achievement and potentially trophy. That's it, 14 out of 14, or 1,000 out of 1,000. Thank you guys so much for watching. Shout out to Love Boat Gopher and Randall.
Alright, here we go. So in order to get this final 14th one, right here, you have to have all previous 13. But there's more to it than that. There's an extra hidden thing. I'll show you. Hey, what's going on? Welcome to the Game Dungeon. I stream video games every night, retro and new games, and I make video game art. So yeah, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13 lights indicating the 13 pods. Check this out. The last one. Alright, hold on. I'm not done yet, you guys. I just maxed out this game for trophies, but we're not done with the weird thing.
Inside secret ending. First things first, you're gonna need to find every collectible orb in the game and break it. There are 12 to find over the course of the game, culminating in the last one that's hiding just before the big chamber where you trigger the escape sequence. If you need help finding the collectibles, be sure to check out our Inside Wiki guide for more details and videos. In this large room, you'll notice a board in the background lit up with a dot for each collectible. With all 12 collected, the hatch to a large orb in the corner will open up, and you can walk inside to disable the final orb. Doing so will cause all the lights to blink out except one. Number two, located in a bunker below the cornfield. This bunker is unlike the other areas of the collectibles as it features some interesting items, like a sealed door with a switch. If you pause the game and load back to that area, you'll find the switch is now active, and pulling it in one of three directions makes ominous musical cues. sounds familiar is probably because you've already heard it elsewhere in the key places in the game, like where the fifth collectible orb is, an alley below the city rooftops. Down and replay back at the bunker. The sequence is as follows.
Anyway, check this out, you guys. You're gonna be like, what? That you can only do this after you have all 14 orbs out of that mothership. I was gonna finish the game and then just go through here, but I don't wanna waste any time. So it's back at the beginning. Actually, I can skip to that part too. You go to the cornfield. This is where there was a collectible, but you were never able to really do anything down here other than get the collectible. But now that you have all of the collectibles, there's a light right here. You grab the switch and you hit up, up, right, left, right, 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 up, 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 right, left, left, left. Here's the super secret ending right here. That's it. What's my internet speed? I have no idea. Why? Can't be bad though. Since I'm constantly running many, many things on my internet. Buying a Wi-Fi connection. I don't know if Wi-Fi is the way to go, man. Well, I mean, it depends on what you're using your internet for. If you're streaming from the PlayStation 4, you definitely want to be hardwired, not wireless. That would be... But yeah, that was the hidden ending, pulling the plug. And that was early in the game, you guys. That was right in the cornfield. Cornfield's right here before you even made... reach the facility. There's another thing I want to try to show you guys though. Here. Let's see. Where is it? All right here. But yeah, that's a super secret. Like, I don't know how anyone figured out the code. But if you look, check this out, Iowa. You see where I'm at? Now take a look inside of here. See that hill and that artificial light? What does that remind you of?
that's the end of the game. This is where the normal ending is later on. It's fucking crazy, dude. It is weird. That part's awesome. That was a fatality. What up, dogs? Somebody's got to cosplay this at a Comic-Con. That would be the best. I don't know how you would pull it off, but I'm sure you could. But yeah, the secret ending's weird. Like, I'm trying to wrap my mind around exactly what this game is all about, man. I thought they were going to climb into the furnace to kill themselves at first. That's what I thought. Now, they remade the Blob multiple times, man. The original Blob's like old school black and white. And then they had one in the 80s, and then they had a newer one. Yeah, Blob's been made at least 4 times. It's weird though, because the boy thinks that he's in control of the mindless guys, and then
the government or the workers in this facility think that they're in charge and in control of the hive mind, and then the game is controlling you in a way. It's kind of weird, dude. Like, I was trying to think about, like, all the things involved in this game, and yeah, it's crazy. And the fact that you die. Yeah, dude, I like that a lot. I'm gonna, my buddy that's from Colorado, he's coming over. I'm gonna show him this whole game. I'm actually gonna let him play it. If we got time. I really think he'll like it. Is that your favorite part, Iowa? That giant sound wave that just blasts you into bits? This is what your testicles look like if you have syphilis. Alright, so what's in the background right here? Are those are all people, huh? And kids? Look at all the kids sitting in the front, dude. That's just creepy. It's like they were waiting for this to happen, you know? It's so messed up. And this is where the game glitched on me, wasn't it? Coming up. Last night, yeah, it was a game-breaking glitch right here. Now you'll probably be able to see it a little better. Nobody puts testicle in the corner. That time it didn't glitch. Yeah, the extra hidden ending is really weird.
Charge. So yeah, this is that same little diorama, scale model part with that light. But yeah, get all 14 and then it starts all over and then you can do the extra hidden ending. That's it, you guys. That's all I got. I did what I set out to do. I wanted to show you all the hidden orbs and the hidden ending. It's weird that I don't see how anyone could figure out that code, though. It's like weird. It's up, up, right, right, left, left, down, right, left, right, 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 something. I don't even know. To open up that hatch. And that light for the hatch isn't even on until you have all 14 of the hidden orbs with the weird UFO being the 14th one. And for Iowa, I will do one part, which is... this part right here. I love how you can see the shockwave, dude, coming. And then time it right. I'm dead. Oh yeah, I've been wearing PlayStation Golds every time I played this game, dude. And it's loud too. It's like a shotgun blast in my ear. But I gotta get to bed, you guys. I have one more night, and then I got some plenty of retro goodness coming your way for sure. So thanks for tuning in. I will definitely get back to more Inside eventually. I might do a Limbo / Inside run on both. And I hope everybody has a good Tuesday. Thanks for stopping in, Fatality, and Chris Fralix, if you're in here, and Iowa, and Maiden, Miss Blush. You guys know who you are. You guys all made me hungry, by the way, but I'm not going to eat anything right before going to bed. But take care, and I'll be on after work again. I'm going to play something. Later.